Hello and welcome to Endwalker Ninja. In this video, I'm going to talk about the changes for Ninja in patch 6.0, discuss our adaptations to the changes, and the reasoning behind them. As I'll be focusing more on the changes to Ninja in Endwalker compared to Shadowbringers, I will not be discussing things that weren't changed, such as how to cast mudras, weapon skills combo, and defensive cooldowns. I will leave a link to my previous video covering those in the description below and at the top right hand corner of the video. Check it out if you're interested. First, let's go through the major changes. We've lost Shadowfang, and Assassinate has merged with Dream Within a Dream. Puton is also now 60 seconds instead of 70. However, we gain Huraijin, a 200 potency GCD that gives 60 seconds of Huton. This is a recovery button in case you drop Huton, which you shouldn't, but I think it's a good button to have, especially during progression. But other than that, you should avoid using it at all costs. Next, we have Phantom Kamaitachi, a 550 potency ranged skill that also hits enemies that are 5 yams around the primary target for half that potency. To use this skill, you need to have the Bunshin buff active. It will also consume 1 Bunshin stack when you activate it, as you are sending your Bunshin clone to attack the enemy. Landing Phantom Kamaitachi also extends Huton by 10 seconds. Finally, there are Forked Raiju and Fleeting Raiju. These are 400 and 450 potency attacks respectively that are also gap closers. After you cast the Raiton, be it a manual cast or the Raiton from Tenchi Jin, you will gain a stack of Forked Raiju ready, which allows you to use Forked Raiju. Once you've used Forked Raiju, you will gain Fleeting Raiju ready, allowing the use of Fleeting Raiju. These stacks can be lost if you activate any of your weapon skills combo, such as Spinning Edge, Gust Slash, and Aeolian Edge, but you can activate any oGCDs and Phantom Kamaitachi without losing the stacks. Therefore, when faced with the situation where you cannot gap close, try to use Phantom Kamaitachi if available, or if not, continue stacking Raiju stacks with Raiton or Tenchi Jin. Here, I'm showing you how the Raiju stacks interact with the rest of your kit. Take note of which skills you can weave in between Raijus and which skills remove the stack. Other changes include Bawakakra can now be buffed by Meisui. Several skills including Katon, Gokamekaku, comboed Hake Mujinsatsu, and Phantom Kamaitachi now interact with Doton to proc Hollow Nozuchi for 50 potency each proc. All in all, these changes allow ninja AoEs to do decent damage in big packs. Hellfrog Medium, however, was nerfed and now should only be used in AoE situations when there are 3 targets or more. Other than that, we are still using the same skills in AoE situations as before: Death Blossom followed by Hake Mujinsatsu, Weave with Katon, Gokamekaku, Phantom Kamaitachi, and Hellfrog Medium. Points to remember are similar from before. Keep Huton up with Armor Crush, except now you have to do it when the timer is below 30 seconds. You should always do your positionals for your weapon skills combo, use Suiton when there is less than 20 seconds cooldown on trick attack, and make sure Suiton was casted before using Kasatsu for the next trick attack window. Not much has changed in oGCD management either. You should use trick attack, Muk, Bunshin, and Tenchi Jin on cooldown. You should also always use Phantom Kamaitachi during the Bunshin windows. In trick attack windows, use Hyosho Ranryu, Dream Within a Dream, and fill in the rest with Raitons followed by Raijus. You should also try to weave in as many Bawakakra as you can and prioritize the buff Bawakakra. This brings us to our level 90 opener. We are now doing a 3 GCD or 7 seconds trick attack. We begin by casting Huton and Doton before hiding to reset our mudra charges. We start with Suiton followed by Kasatsu, weaving our potion between Spinning Edge and Gust Slash. Next, we double weave Muk and Bunshin followed by Aeolian Edge and Trick Attack. Try to delay the trick as long as you can without clipping your GCD. This helps align your second trick attack later and also to fit in the last Forked Raiju in the trick window. Next, we do Phantom Kamaitachi weaving Dream Within the Dream followed by Hyosho Ranryu. Next, Raiton into Tenchi Jin casting Fuma, Raiton, and Suiton, followed by Meisui. Now we spam Raijus and Bawakakras. Following the Forked Raiju that is under trick, we Raiton before continuing our Raiju spam. A frequently asked question is why Phantom Kamaitachi over Bunshin Aeolian in trick? This is because, assuming your target is pulled onto your Doton, the Hollow Nozuchi proc with Doton, in addition to Phantom's potency, is higher than Bunshin Aeolian. However, if you're facing an immobile target, it's better for you to swap Aeolian and Phantom around. A point to note that while currently most jobs are wanting a 3 GCD or 7 seconds trick attack, this might change in the future as new details emerge. When that happens, I will provide an updated video accordingly. Thank you for watching and have a good one.